So this one's on this side. So I want to create this deep ear canal, and then all this you can mix right into the jawline, right? That looks pretty good. Comes this way. And then this loop at the bottom here. You can put dark in there, and that'll help shape that. Ricola. All right, so when I turn that over, that gave me that side. So now I'm gonna put this here. Did I do that right? Ah, so now actually it's this way. Okay, that's a good way to do the other side. Just turn it, so, and that'll be the other side. So look at where your eye is, look at where the ear goes, and then knit it in there. I mean, worst case scenario, you can just pull it out. If you don't get it right. Okay. So that's the ears. Okay, I put my eyes in. Use the 7mm. Not all of these are the same size, so make sure you look at them. Make sure that, see, this one looks smaller to me. Let's see. Now those look pretty much the same. And if you find these are too long, you can always cut them off because look, that's pretty long. And I gotta poke a deeper hole in there. This line bothers me. It doesn't really have that, you see. I think I might have to add on to that nose tip a little bit. All right, but let's get these set. So this comes this way. Actually, I'm gonna push it this way. Sure you keep the skull between the ears. Just add a little in there. Right? Back of his head. Think about squirrel ears as they kind of stand straight up. Towards this way a little bit. And then I kind of want to depress this down. put them in dry to make sure they're in the right place. I'm not gonna make a bigger. Yeah, I am gonna cut some of that off. Nifty snippers. Now that should go in there. Good. Oop, sticking to my finger. Okay. Now look at the face of it. Sure, it's across from the other one. Make the socket. Cut this off too. Oh, that one went right on in there, so that's good. Now make sure they look even. So I used to pull these out, but I don't do that anymore. Just pull them out a little bit and then put the glue in here. Move it around a little bit and put it right in there. Right, now this one's longer, so it'll be easier. Move it around a little bit. Put it right in there. And that's your eyes, so. Now the next thing we'll do is to start to color this. I've got my quills. Look at these. And these are for the whiskers. And so I can just cut those off. I can have white ones or black ones. I like to have this end because it tapers to a point, whereas if you cut it off, then you're going to have a blunt end, say like this one. But then I get a white and a black. But that's not until the very last thing. But see, if you go like this with your nail, you can make it curve, and then when you put it in there, it's not straight out. See, because straight out is no good. Then you're looking at a rat. So, just pull and curve it. Ooh, look how curly that went. See, I did it too hard. Maybe I could straighten that out. Oh, yeah, awesome. Now, if I could fish this through, I could get two in one. All right. Next step, color the squirrel. I'm going to let the glue dry for the eyes because I don't want them to move. And then we'll go on to coloring. I'll use my Carter and show you how to mix the colors. See, now look, sometimes this thing will start to look like a lamb.